You've more than likely forgotten to return a library book, but how about decades past its due date? That's what happened to a book checked out from Rogers High School. And KXY4's John Hendricks explains how a classic found its way home.
The yellow stains on these pages, battle scars from taking young minds to Treasure Island or Where the Wild Things Are.
It's a 1946 copy of Gone with the Wind.
The words inside this book, not the only thing telling the story. It's about a journey even Scarlett O'Hara couldn't imagine.
Betty Mandanshire was the last one to have checked it out on January 4th, 1949.
65 years after Betty took this book from the library, it has made a cross-country journey back home.
You don't imagine someone keeping a book for that long and then actually returning it.
No one at Rogers even knew it was gone until they received a handwritten letter from a man with no connections to this Spokane high school.
As far as he knew, his dad had never been to Washington and certainly had never been in Spokane. So he has no idea how the book got to Carmel, Maine.
The author explains he found the book inside a cellar owned by his dad, and he was trying to find its rightful owner.
As long as I don't have to pay the late fee that is listed in the back of the book at 2 cents a day, that would be around $470. I was not around in 1949. I was born in 1957, ha ha.
How it made its way to the East Coast is still a bit of a mystery. And even now, it's not going back on the shelf.
I'm thinking it's kind of near the entrance so students can see that and maybe it'll inspire them to return their books.
This all-time classic now has a new ending back home in Spokane. Reporting from Rogers High School, John Hendricks, KXLY 4 News.
Love.